Aside of being Mia and Barry's channel, I thought of sharing about a special pet in my life that I feel like it needs to be shared for those who decide to become part of our lives. This video is all about my very first pet ever. Her name was Hope. She was a beautiful orange tabby cat who passed away last year to leukemia. Before we get into the sad part of the story of how we lost her, I would like to share the happy part of when she came into my life and taught me many things. Things I would never would have done on my own. I feel like sharing my previous own pets for the first year, like Hope and Elmer, will be necessary since I will probably mention them. So if you guys ever ask who Hope and Elmer were, I will have a link to those videos if necessary. Let's start at the beginning when my mom took me to her work for Take Your Child to Work Day. Usually your parent is supposed to take you back to school after you are finished, but instead my mom took me to local pet stores that offer rescued cats such as Petco and PetSmart. First, we went to Petco since it was closer to our location. There was this 5-year-old cat that we looked at. There was nothing wrong with the age of the cat or anything. The only thing that stopped us from looking at that cat that day was the manager wasn't there. We did put a hold on the cat that day, but what we didn't know is that we were going to meet our perfect little nugget at PetSmart. And that's where we met Hope. The next location we went to was PetSmart in Pittsburgh, which we lived in Pittsburgh about 14 years. We went to look at the cats, and there were at least 2 little 4-month-old kittens that caught our eye. My mom asked the manager if he could see the 2 kittens. One kitten was orange and more white on her, and the other one was orange with white on her muzzle. After a long decision, we decided to take the orange kitten with white on her muzzle. Now you're wondering, why did you name her Hope? Again, I was 9 years old and couldn't think of a name, so I looked at these photos with writing, and that was behind my mom and the manager. After looking and looking, I spotted the name Hope, so we decided to name her Hope. And funny thing is, her name really had meaning than I realized at that moment. From the moment she came home, we instantly connected. Like, I don't know what it is, but cats seem to like me a lot more than dogs do. Even Mia and Elmer picked me, but these two will get their own video at a different time. Hope followed me everywhere, slept with me, and even was there when I did my homework. She thought she was helping. But the truth she was in it for the pencil. Hope was also a great lap warmer. She would lay in my lap until she was satisfied. She would even look up at you, and you could tell she was loved very much. Hope was with me throughout my whole time in school, which made it extra special, because I knew there was someone always there for me when I needed her most. She lived in 3 houses in her entire life, which not many cats get to explore that much territory during their years on Earth. As much as I loved Hope, she did come with a few medical issues. The moment we brought her home, she always had respiratory issues and a sensitive stomach, which got worse as she got older. Have you ever heard of the myth saying cats have 9 lives? Well, I can tell you one thing. Hope certainly had 9. Her stomach issues worsened over time, and I had to give her a pill as well as a special raw diet since her stomach couldn't do regular kibble anymore, since all she would do was throw it up. As for her respiratory issues, we would go see the vet for a prescription for at least every 3 months. Hope did often have bad days where she would not be herself, then perk up the next. She kept vomiting and wanted to be by herself in her box bed that she loved, which scared me very much so because Hope loved when I came home from school, as she would meow up a storm and lay in my lap for hours. So I told my mom and dad the situation, and we put her on fluids immediately. I would get up in the middle of the night and give her fluids. She did perk up a little, as she didn't fight me at all in giving her fluids. She was even starting to walk a little bit, and she loved laying on a heating pad I gave her. I treated her like she was my patient and gave her anything she needed. I was off work that day. I was playing doctor, which I was more than happy. I had the whole day with her because I didn't know she would be taking her last breath the next day. After waking up and finding out that she pooped all over herself, I gave her a bath, and that same morning I had to go to work, which you could probably imagine it being not so pretty. I went to work, and while I was at work, she walked downstairs all by herself and laid down in the sunroom, which she loved that room for a final time. What amazes me is she used all her energy and strength to walk downstairs and enjoy her final moments. Luckily, my dad was home to keep an eye on her. All of a sudden, he said she just collapsed. He rushed her to our regular vet and told them it was an emergency. He picked me up at work and took me to the vets, and they said her gums were all white. I was all in shock that this was happening. I wanted to know why. But they said if they tried to take blood work, she would most likely pass due to the state she was in. I asked if there was any other way we could see what was going on without stressing her, and that is doing an ultrasound. So we went to a vet in our area that did that. We did have an ultrasound done on her before at the same vet. But when we got there, they said the vet that did the ultrasound wasn't there that day. In order to get pure closure, I told him to do blood work, even though she could pass during the process. I can tell you one thing, she stayed during the whole time, knowing she wanted to see me one more time before she passed. We got the test results back, and it turned out to be leukemia, which we didn't even know. Like, she never showed any signs that she was suffering, but that's the thing about cats, they never tell you until it's too late. The vet asked me if I wanted to see her again in her final moments, and I said yes. Hope and I glanced at each other one more time, and she passed on. My mom and dad were there with me for an hour to mourn, then it was time to go. Even though she's gone, her legacy still lives. I want everyone who subscribes to know the pet that started everything. In the first year, I definitely want to do these types of videos, like the next one we will do on Elmer, which is another cat we had, who passed on April 25th, 2016. Thank you for those who have watched and listened to the story of Hope. I know I didn't share most of her whole life, but you could probably get a great picture of who she really was. She was an amazing cat, and this video is very hard for me to do, so I appreciate you guys watching me tell the story of Hope's life, how we got her, what she was like, and how she left this world.